I can't encourage people enough to get out there and use resources like libraries to research. So this is Sydney Harbour right here. The main CBD of the city of Sydney is right here. Now, the library used to be in town, but it has moved out to here. And we're now in the region of St. Leonard's right here. And it's just in Albany Street here. So the Pacific Highway runs through here. And we'll have a look at that now. So this is the Pacific Highway. Busy. And Albany Street is right here. And the entrance to the Theosophy House is now just over here. And it's a great new facility for the library. It's a place where you can go and you may run into some interesting people in places like this. Here at 599, the abode, and further up here is the library. Again, the doorway right here. So here is the opening hours that you'd want to ring in and check, and the facility is up here.
There it is.
Yeah, thanks guys. Okay, so there's a bit of a front desk here. We'll go up the stairs. And so this is the Theosophical Society, and there are various figures around. This is kind of a front room where they can have the talks. They've got all the chairs here and the front speaking desk right there with the lotus going through, looking sort of out onto the street. Some artwork right here. And then looking through, the toilets are sort of through here and the library is through this way, the kitchen right here. Madame Blavatsky, Petrovna Blavatsky, is a huge figure within Theosophy. So here she is right here, her portrait, little plaque. Interesting architectural sort of a cabinet right there. Many things like that, little statues and bits and pieces. The kitchenette where you can make yourself, or maybe not staff only, but make yourself a cup of tea. Now that would be your sort of flat earth in a way, but there you have the four participants around the center. And we can see that everywhere. Don't even need to sort of mention this stuff. The always standing on the figure here, we'll get into that at some stage, but the aura around there, the fire, the figure within the fire there, Kali, or whatever particular figure that happens to be. Going through here, Graham up here, he's helped me out finding various books in the past, and bits of information here and there. Can see the aura just down by Graham here. You can see another book here with the aura, the sun up here, moon over here. It's kind of divided figure with the colors and all the rest of it. Interesting stuff, many interesting books. And as we continue through the veil, various lots of subject matters covered in these libraries, and you just can't get a lot of this stuff on the internet. There's just too much information, so I certainly can't cover a lot of it in my videos. That's why I sort of say to people, you know, get these books that I've referenced and used others as well. So there's more books down this side with various themes, lots of themes. You can see there the various main religions, Buddhism, Hinduism, all the rest of it, Islam. three graces there. Kind of auric world right there with various symbolism coming through. And we see that represented. So, just having a look through many subjects through here. So this is back to the main desk right here. So I do encourage people to come to these sort of places. You may even meet very interesting people within these sorts of facilities, these sorts of libraries around the world. As an outsider, if you show information, if you're not just all biased and like, oh, they're evil and all that sort of thing, and I'm so self-righteous, if you don't have that sort of chip on your shoulder, so to speak, then you may get somewhere with people. If you've just got this attitude that this person's going to be an evil person, and in comparison with yourself, then I don't know that you would get very far. But I do encourage people to get to these places and read the books and use these sort of facilities. The chakra system right here really sums a lot of things up as to what a lot of the literature would be alluding to, particularly within the religious texts that the average reader really has no idea about. They have no idea about what they're reading. And this would include myself regarding many aspects.